I'm fine, James. Thanks for asking.
I'm sorry, I don't understand.
I know, but I finally do.
Next.
I'll take the chef's special.
Is that with chicken or...
Congratulations. Looks like a huge success.
I wasn't expecting you.
Couldn't miss your grand opening.
So where's your CEO?
I ended that.
Dominic, he may have all the money in the world and all the power, but he doesn't have half your potential.
Stop. Stop. All right, I don't need you to do that for me anymore. I'm doing me now, all right? Thanks for coming. I got a business to run. I'm sure you can respect that, right? Next!
Hey, what's good here, man? Do you have a low-fat pork special?
Sure.
Let's roll.
Dominic!
What are you doing?
I want you back, Dominic.
Guys, just give me a minute, please. I know. What are you doing?
I want you back.
Yeah, I listen, I'm not an acquisition. You can't just decide.
I'm asking.
Oh, yeah? And I'm asking for some service.
You get your pork sausage, Porky! Beat it!
Lauren, listen, we're just too different, okay?
Yes, we are different. But I think that's a good thing.
What you need is status. You need titles.
No, I don't.
I don't care about.
Oh, no, no. What I need is a man who makes me feel like I'm special. I don't care about his title, and I don't care how much money you make. I don't care what kind of car you drive. I need you. Please. I'm sorry.
I think ultimately we want different things.
No. I disagree. I think we want the exact same thing.
What's that?
Well, first, I would like to have my chef special hold pork.
Baby, tonight's the night I let you know. Baby, tonight's the night we lose control.
Go down!
All right, come on, man. That's enough kissing. Grab an ass or something. Do something, God. Give me something to think about tonight. You know I ain't having that much sex. Me and Gail ain't really doing it like we used to.
Really, Cedric?
Come on now.
Get your little ass over here,
Gail.
Now.
I'm joking, Gail.
Yeah,
I'm
joking, yeah.
Gail.
Pull your pants up, Cedric.
Gail.
Don't be
Gail.
Well, I just did that.
This is what it's all about.
It made me want to get up and dance.
Yeah! I can tell you love what you do.
I love it like this much.
The season premiere of So You Think You Can Dance, Next Generation, premieres Monday, May 30th on Fox. He's conquered talent in competition shows.
Welcome to paradise!
He's reimagined the boardroom and the art of the pitch.
We need your swag level on a trip.
On May 17th, Mark Burnett sets his sights on love.
How cool is that?
It's really going to be up to the girls to see if they want to take it further with you.
I surely thought that this might be it. Look at my hands. Shaking!
On this island, everyone has a chance to get coupled.
Love is in the air.
May 17th on Fox.
Now on Fox Rochester, wildlife warning.
A coyote advisory issued. How big of a deal is it? And what you need to know.
I am guilty. I'm guilty of many mistakes.
A tearful apology and a message to taxpayers from a local businessman convicted of bid rigging. And did they bite? How a local woman's business pitch did on Shark Tank.
You're watching Fox Rochester. And this is 13 WHAM News at 10.
A warning tonight to be on the lookout for coyotes. Art Kirsch already had a close encounter at his home in Ontario County.
Lo and behold, it was a coyote on hot pursuit of our two labs.
This is the time of year to spot coyotes, and it's becoming more common because coyotes are becoming less afraid of humans. 13 WAM's Amy Hudak is live now with tips to keep them at a safe distance. Amy?
Jenny, this is something the DEC says that we need to be aware of. They say be sure to keep all cats inside. Only let dogs out at night when it's like this if they're on a leash. And to keep bird feeders and trash out of sight and out of reach. Wildlife expert Art Kirsch said last week his wife had her first encounter with a coyote while walking their two labs.
We heard some yipping and thought it was another dog chasing our dogs, and lo and behold, it was a coyote on hot pursuit of our two labs.
Kirsch says he's not surprised by her experience and the DEC's coyote advisory.
This is the time of year when coyotes are having their young. They're in their dens. Most of the pups have probably been born by now. But it's not something to be afraid of. It's just something to be aware of.
Local vets say coyotes are a major reason pets go missing.
Most of the time, the coyotes aren't going to let their prey go. Simplest things would be to not let your pets roam at night. Take them out on a leash, bring them back in.
Piper Gasiorowski goes to RIT and said she's seen several social media alerts.
They tell us to not let our animals or pets outside because there are coyotes that will be around the area, especially by the river.
She says she's keeping a closer eye on her pets.
I have my own cat. We keep him inside all times.
Coyotes can be a problem if they approach people or if they don't look healthy. The DEC is asking anybody who's experienced an encounter with a coyote to get in touch with them. Live in Henrietta, Amy Hudak, 13 WAM News at 10 on Fox Rochester.
All right, thank you, Amy. A law enforcement officer is in custody after police say he went on a deadly rampage. Three people were killed, three others wounded in three separate shootings around Maryland within 24 hours. As Mary Maloney reports, the gunman knew at least one of his victims.
Three separate locations, a school, a grocery store, and a mall.
The whole thing has been very shocking.
Police say Thursday, a Federal Protection Service officer, Eulalo Tordil, shot and killed his estranged wife outside of a high school as she waited to pick up her kids. Police say Tordil also shot a man who tried to help her. Friday, deadly shots rang out at a grocery store and a mall. Again, police pointed to the Federal Protection Service officer.
It's tragic that we were not able to intervene prior to additional victims being harmed.
Tordil hasn't been active with the FPS since March. That's when investigators say he was placed on administrative leave after a protective order was issued against him. The law enforcement officer had to turn in his duty weapon, badge, and credentials. Shortly after police pointed to Tordil as a possible suspect to the three shootings, they took him into custody.
Now we can restore some degree of peace.
But the investigation into the killings and the motive for the murders has only just begun. I'm Mary Maloney reporting.
Local businessman Dan Lynch begins his term in prison tonight. He and two others were sentenced today for a Monroe County bid rigging scheme through local development corporations, or LDCs. Lynch was the ringleader and admitted to stealing $200,000 from the county. He'll spend the next 2 to 6 years in state prison and will have to pay back $600,000 to Monroe County.
I am guilty. I'm guilty of many mistakes. I'm absolutely ready to take accountability for my actions. I want to apologize to this court. I want to apologize to the citizens of Monroe County.
Two others, Nelson Rivera and John Maggio, received lesser sentences that do not include jail time. A fourth defendant, Robert Wiesner, the husband of former Monroe County executive Maggie Brooks, pleaded guilty in January and avoided jail time as well. County executive Cheryl DeNolfo says she continues to work towards the dissolution of LDCs. At the center of that case, she has submitted legislation to the state legislature to assist in that process. The Lilac Festival is underway at Highland Park, and it was just voted one of the top 10 places to visit in the world for the month of May. While not all the buds are blooming yet, the lilacs are expected to reach their peak next week. Glenn is here now to tell us if the weather will cooperate.
Well, Jenny, it's a long festival. Eventually, we're going to get some pretty good weather. And overall, we'll say the weather is going to be cooperating. Take a look at the HD WAMCAM this evening. We have lots of clouds. Temperature, it's reasonable. We're at 55 degrees this evening. We're watching still some showers east of Rochester. And take a look at the time lapse here. You can see how they're drifting through central New York, and we think they're going to head towards Rochester. So later tonight, a couple of sprinkles, a little shower is going to be a possibility. But we expect by the morning, most of that is going to be done with. So we're going to start out with a mix of clouds and sunshine for your Saturday morning. The temperature right around 50 degrees. By midday, we're going to find partial sunshine, and it's going to be warming up. In fact, it's one of the warmest days we expect in quite a while. Today, we get to 64. Tomorrow, we should be near 70. Now, late in the day, towards the evening, there's going to be the chance of a shower. So it's not going to be perfect out there. And we're going to show you some bigger changes for Mother's Day. It's coming up.
All right, thank you, Glenn. A disturbing video shows a student attacking a classmate in the library of Williamson High School in January. The teen who allegedly threw the punch now faces charges and possible prison time if convicted.
I don't think probation is enough of a punishment, frankly, on an act of violence like this. If it's violence and somebody's injured, you know, jail may be appropriate, and I think it is in this case.
The victim needed stitches. A grand jury indicted 16-year-old Augustus Phillips on assault charges. Police say a Rochester man set a house on fire to try and keep his ex-girlfriend from testifying against him. Police say 48-year-old Todd Griffin set the fire with the help of 22-year-old Luis Torres. Five adults and four children had to break a window to get out. Investigators later found the windows and a side door had been nailed shut.
And I'm happy he's locked up and that she's safe and she can get on with her life and she doesn't have to worry about her life and her son's life.
No one was injured in that fire on Campbell Street last weekend. In Syracuse, four children and two adults are dead after an overnight fire. Neighbors say they heard an explosion at the family's home and flames were already coming from the house when firefighters arrived. One woman was able to escape. Harris RF has landed another major deal. The $405 million contract is with the U.S. Army for ground and airborne radio systems. Senator Schumer says the deal will support local jobs and help the region's economy. And perhaps a sign of new things to come in Irondequoit, the Medley Center sign came down today. A local developer bought the property earlier this year at auction. He has not yet said what he plans to do. Sears, the last remaining store at the mall, will close this summer. It was very possibly the pitch of a lifetime, and on TV, no less. A Rochester baker told investors on Shark Tank on 13 Wham ABC why her gourmet frosting deserved funding. And 13 Wham's Jennifer Lee is live at Wegmans in Pittsburgh, where people gathered to watch to see how Heather Saffer did. What was the outcome, Jen?
Yeah, there was a lot of excitement. It was dead quiet when the show was actually on and Saffer was on the air. But a lot of people were definitely cheering for her, and they thought that she would get a deal, and she got really close. This was their response after that air. Now, her company is called Dollop Gourmet Frosting. She asked for a $75,000 investment for a 20% stake in her company. She says she got the shark that she wanted, Barbara, and she got it for a 25% stake in her company. She says she's grateful for this opportunity and the support.
This is a crazy opportunity. I mean, I knew going into it that this would be like, it's like a massive commercial for your brand.
I'm trying not to cry. She has worked so hard for this, and I am just so proud of her.
I thought it was awesome.
Now, Saffer is also no stranger to the television show. She was also a winner of Cupcake Wars, and she also often makes appearances on our show, Good Day Rochester, and she will be on Good Day Rochester this coming Monday, Jenny.
Well, that's great. A lot to celebrate. I mean, she's in.
Yeah, she's definitely in. And then after her part, her segment aired, she also told everyone there's Dollop Gourmet Frosting right outside in Wegmans if you want to buy some.
Like a good businesswoman. All right, thank you. And Wegmans got a shout out on Shark Tank as well.
How are you selling it now?
We're selling it in retail stores. So I launched the company less than a year ago in all 85 Wegmans locations a couple of months
ago. That is a great store.
It is.
We all agree, right? Praise for Wegmans and Heather Saffer. Congratulations to her tonight. And still ahead on Fox Rochester, the new claim about the late Joe Paterno, plus the battle to save a burning Canadian city, how people became trapped in the flames. And hear a father's emotional plea to learn what happened to his son lost at sea.
Kids crossing the border illegally, now facing dangers in America worse than those they fled, on the next Full Measure.
Sunday on 13 WHAM ABC and Fox Rochester.
The Modern Family Guide to Raising Modern Kids. Build up your child's self-esteem.
Think about me going off to college. Why are you smiling?
I didn't think you'd get in.
Modern Family, nightly.
Weeknights at 6 and 6:30 on Fox Rochester.
There's a place for you at Tryon Estates. An outdoor place. A relaxing place. A happy place. A place that's cared for us year-round and loved by you day in and day out. Tryon Estates, a carefree place to call home.
Is your truck more than just a ride to you? New Look Accessories has everything you need to take your truck to the next level. From bump steps and Nerf bars to truck caps and window guards, you'll find a large selection at great prices at New Look Accessories, 2111 Empire Boulevard in Webster.
Oh! What? That was an easy call. She was safe.
No, I guarantee she was out.
I'll give you a guarantee with Frontier. They gave me a 2-year price guarantee on high-speed internet.
Now, that's an easy call.
So was that one.
Get a 2-year price guarantee with Frontier high-speed internet for just $19.99 per month with qualifying phone service and 1-year agreement on new internet service. Plus, get a $100 Frontier Visa reward card. The choice is easy. Call 1-888-FRONTIER now.
It's spring clearance time at Sleep City, and every mattress set is clearance priced from 20 to 30% off sale prices. And remember,
your comfort is always our guarantee.
Say goodnight, get the best night's sleep.
It's finally here, the grand opening of the newest Country Max on West Henrietta Road. Come celebrate Saturday and Sunday, May 14th and 15th, and get more with Country Max than ever before. There's prizes, giveaways, and demonstrations. All 15 area Country Max stores are celebrating with super savings. You'll find an acre of supplies for pets, wild birds, and staple, plus all you need for home, lawn, and garden. Don't miss the grand opening celebration of our newest Country Max store on West Henrietta Road. You get more with Max, Country Max.
Take the ride of your life. Join the Manning and Napier Tour de Cure to benefit the American Diabetes Association. It's Saturday, June 11th at the Xerox Complex in Webster. Visit diabetes.org/Rochester Tour for details.
The fire consuming a city in Alberta, Canada, could double in size by the end of tomorrow. By road and by plane, Canadian authorities are moving thousands of evacuees farther away from that massive wildfire in Fort McMurray. Diana Gallagher has this report.
As the fire that turned the northern Canadian town of Fort McMurray into an inferno rages on,
It's something like you'd see out of the movies.
With smoke blacking out the sun.
And a disaster movie. We lived it.
I'm scared to go back.
And showers of embers raining down on the Alberta city.
Absolutely apocalyptic.
Exhausted evacuees prepare to make a break for it again. Friday morning, Canadian officials began the massive task of escorting families back through Fort McMurray. They had fled north to escape the flames, but found themselves trapped by Highway 63, the only highway in or out of the town. And now the convoy of about 1,500 vehicles must be escorted back through the dangerous situation to get safely south to shelters in Edmonton and Calgary, traveling in small groups for safety.
It's just the fire seems to be spreading around town and coming back in and out, and seems to be going further out all the time. So we're trying to keep track of it, but the wind keeps changing directions.
More than 90,000 people have been forced to leave.
It is apparent that the damage to the community of Fort McMurray is extensive, and the city is not safe for residents at this time.
Right now, no one is making any predictions on when it will be safe to return. In Washington, Diane Gallagher.
To politics tonight, House Speaker Paul Ryan and Donald Trump will have a chance to work out their differences. The two will meet Thursday. It follows comments by Ryan that he is not ready to back Trump for the GOP presidential nomination. A new court filing claims former Penn State football coach Joe Paterno knew that his assistant coach, Jerry Sandusky, was sexually abusing a child as early as 1976. That's 12 years before what had been the earliest known allegation of abuse by Sandusky. Penn State says it doesn't have records from 40 years ago to help evaluate that claim.
I can't sleep at times not knowing what happened.
The father of one of two teens lost at sea is fighting to get access to his son's iPhone. It was recovered recently along with the boat. A judge ordered it to be turned over to Apple to be analyzed.
I'm his father. Nobody else is his father. I am Perry's father. I have every right to that information just like anybody else does.
Both families of the teens who disappeared say they hope information from the iPhone can shed light on the boys' intentions and location that day.
Well, maybe you got a chance to take a look at that sunset, and even if you didn't this evening, I'll show you a nice picture. This was sent in by one of our co-workers at Channel 13. Paul Stella was out at Winton Road Bridge here looking down the Erie Canal, and look at that sunset, the sun getting below the clouds, really brightening up the sky significantly, and obviously that's a good sign for tomorrow. Now, this time of the year, you know, we still can get snow, and I wanted to show you this. This is, we're coming up on the anniversary 27 years ago where we got a significant snowfall in Rochester. It actually is tomorrow. This was sent in by John. Originally, he lived out in Batavia. We got 10 inches of that heavy, wet snow. Had a lot of tree branches coming down, if you remember that. It was, well, it was a rough start to the spring season. No snow coming our way, and at least right now on the HD Wham Cam, we got mostly cloudy skies, temperatures at 55 degrees, the wind is calm. But look at this little swirl in the clouds and the precipitation. When you see that counterclockwise movement, that tells us where low pressure is located, and some of this moisture coming in from an unusual direction, coming in from the east, will start to get into the Rochester area later tonight. Now, not a big deal. We're not looking at a lot of precipitation, but a couple of showers sometime around 1, 2, 2:30 in the morning. I think it'll fade away as we go through the early morning hours, and once we get to 9 a.m., I think it's going to be a blend of clouds and sunshine. I think it's going to start to warm up because we're going to get more of a southerly wind. And then we'll have to watch late in the afternoon. I think towards 5 or 6 o'clock, there's going to be the chance of a little shower. Let me show you the zone forecast here as we go across western New York. And on the east side, Canandaigua, Victor, you're going to be near 70 with a mix of clouds and sun. On the west side, better chance that you could get one of these showers late in the day, but the temperature is still in the upper 60s. Watch as we go through time here. There's that southerly wind. It's going to last for one day. It's going to last on Saturday. Then the cold front goes through. You know what happens, right? Yeah, the temperature starts to drop. It's going to be a little breezy. We'll get another shower or a rumble of thunder. This is going to be for Sunday, for Mother's Day. So for the overnight, we're down to about 48 degrees. Another shower developing again later tonight. Maybe a little bit of fog in some of the valleys. Tomorrow morning, I think we start to break out of this. We'll call it a blend of clouds and sunshine. Temperature is going to go up rapidly through the 50s into the 60s. And ultimately, we get close to about 70. And again, late in the afternoon, if not by late in the afternoon, by the evening, certainly we get a couple of showers that are going to be popping up, but not a lot of precipitation. The extended outlook Sunday, yeah, a couple of showers, maybe even some thunder. Breezy and cooler as we go through Sunday and Monday. We'll get some drier weather as we go through early next week, and a couple of showers going through Wednesday and Thursday. My prediction, based on the weather, that it's going to be pretty crowded at Highland tomorrow. I would think so.
Yeah.
They were busy out there today by some of the pictures that we saw.
Yeah, and things only get better, really, in terms of the blossoms from here on out.
We'll get them going.
All right, thanks, Glenn. Hundreds of Greece Arcadia students and staff members returned to school tonight. They came to remember Ms. Flick, the school principal who died last week following a battle with breast cancer. Principal Flick was beloved by students and staff alike. She was remembered for treating them like family and taking an interest in getting to know each and every one. Just ahead on Fox Rochester, what new numbers show about the gender pay gap, why Walmart is about to get a little friendlier, and the rising jackpot where you can see tomorrow's winning Powerball numbers first.
Bob Johnson Chevrolet. than 30 years ago, Canandaigua National Bank and Trust helped get Commodore Plastics up and running. We're still banking with CNB. They support our economy by investing in local businesses like ours.
Canandaigua National Bank and Trust, investing in you, your business, and your community.
Are you building, remodeling, or making any home improvements? Take your first step at findthehomepros.com, your local planning source. No fees or registration. Find local professionals with the highest standards. Go to findthehomepros.com.
It's the Great American Upholstery Sale. Every sofa, loveseat, chair, and recliner is made in America and on sale now. Save up to 40% store-wide. American made, all on sale. Celebrate American craftsmanship and quality at Mount Morris Furniture.
And we're off with another great deal with award-winning 14 Hands wine for $5.99. Hi, it's Leanne from Lisa's Liquor Barn. 14 Hands in 8 varietals like Hot to Trot, Red and White, Stampede, Red Blend, and more. You pay $7.99 per bottle and save even more with a $24 mail-in rebate. Your final cost just $5.99. That's right, just $5.99. Only at Lisa's Liquor Barn in Penfield. Why pay more?
For 70 years, the Dorschel family has lived in and served Western New York. The most important thing we've learned during that time is that each customer is unique and has different needs. That's why we put so much effort into training our people, updating our facilities, and dramatically changing our sales process to recognize the different needs of each customer. I'm in the dealerships every day, striving to make our family business best in class at being there for the things our customers need most. So log on at Dorschel.com or stop in on West Henrietta Road so we can deliver what you need most.
Before earning enough cash back from Bank of America to buy a new gym bag, before earning 1% cash back everywhere, every time, and 2% back at the grocery store, even before he got 3% back on gas, Kenny used his Bank AmeriCard Cash Rewards credit card to join the Wednesday Night League because he loves to play hoops, not jump through them. That's the excitement of rewarding connections. Apply online or at a Bank of America near you.
Rochester Colonial.
He's a proud sponsor of the 13 WHAM Weather Line. Call 334-0013 to get the latest forecast anytime from the 13 WHAM Weather Authority.
The gender pay gap is growing as millions get set to graduate this month. New numbers show female grads are now earning even less than before. The Economic Policy Institute says the average woman out of college makes $16.50 an hour compared to $20.94 for men. On top of that, getting a job is tougher, as studies suggest young college grads are competing with more experienced workers for fewer jobs. Get ready to be greeted the next time you go into Walmart. The nation's largest retailer is bringing back its greeter position. Walmart says it expects to fill about 9,000 of these new hourly positions. The Powerball jackpot now stands at $415 million after nobody won Wednesday's drawing. And remember, you can see the winning numbers first tomorrow night at Fox Rochester just before the 11 o'clock news. Then you can switch over to 13 WHAM to see them again. Good luck. Coming up on Fox Rochester, a fight over pet meds. The government with a plan to lower the cost, but we'll tell you why some veterinarians are fighting it.
And later in sports, a Bills rookie doesn't get the whole idea of the buffalo chicken wings.
I've tasted a great chicken wing. How better can it be here?
That and who paid a visit on the field later in sports.
My brain is better than everybody's.
See the world through Sheldon Vision.
Why don't you and I go for a nice walk together?
Everything is just sex with you, isn't it?
The Big Bang Theory.
Weeknights at 7 and 7:30 on Fox Rochester.
Make your day supreme with Dunkin's new Bacon Supreme Omelet Breakfast Sandwich, loaded with peppers, onions, and potatoes, and topped with 2 slices of Cherrywood smoked bacon and cheese, all on a freshly baked croissant. America runs on Dunkin'.
Been hit head-on, rear-ended, or T-boned? The moments after any car crash are critical. Don't wait. Call 8.
Day in and day out, we are focused on car accident cases.
Our car accident lawyers are available 24/7 to answer your questions.
Savino and Barnes, injury attorneys. Call 888-8888.
Don't wait. Call 8.
Here's the guy that won 100,000 last year, Donald Bovee from up in Adams.
Hey, we're
back. It's unbelievable.
We're back. Yes.
Oh, we're back. This month, all over the state, Albany, Rochester, Syracuse, Watertown, Buffalo. Listen to me. It's a $250,000 giveaway. Go into any Facilo store, register, and guess what?
23 winners.
$250,000. You're going to take my jet. You're going to go to Jamaica.
All the
you're
going to
party
price.
For a week. It's
all
exciting.
The savings.
Inventory. Folks, don't miss the opportunity. Right here in the state of New York, statewide, it's going to be huge.
I've noticed you here every morning.
I noticed you always get off at this stop.
Yeah. You?
Jefferson Street.
Maybe we can grab a bite to eat someday.
Maybe someday.
It's someday.
Sure is.
Brighten your morning with a hot, freshly brewed cup of McCafe coffee. And get any size for just $1.
Sip into summertime with Dunkin's Frozen Coolada. Freeze up the flavors of summer with a blue raspberry or any other small frozen coolada for $1.99. America runs on Dunkin'.
Monday morning on Good Day Rochester, Hannah's going RVing. And who's the funniest person in Rochester? We'll tell you about a hilarious contest.
Monday on Good Day Rochester. All local, all morning.
The Federal Trade Commission wants to throw tens of millions of pet owners a bone. But veterinarians say proposed federal legislation will jeopardize the health of cats and dogs. The law known as the Fairness to Pet Owners Act aims to lower the cost of prescription drugs for pets. Here is national correspondent Christine Frizzow.
Sit. Good.
Do pet owners get the short end of the stick buying prescription drugs from a veterinarian?
Surprisingly, she's been a little bit expensive already.
According to the Federal Trade Commission, pet owners spent more than $7.5 billion in 2013 on prescription drugs and over-the-counter medicines for their furry friends.
The FTC tells us veterinarians typically earn 20% or more from selling prescription meds and usually have exclusive deals with pet pharma companies.
We think that consumers would benefit if they had greater access to portable prescriptions so that they could take their prescriptions and shop around.
Democratic Representative Jan Schakowsky, testifying at a House hearing recently, says competition remains stifled because veterinarians all but have a lock on pet prescriptions.
The pet medication industry needs fair competition.
But the American Veterinary Medical Association says three dozen states now have laws or regulations on the books that compel veterinarians to write portable prescriptions. In states where no mandate exists, pet docs are bound by ethical guidelines to write one upon request.
And it's just going to add an extra layer of bureaucracy and burden to veterinary practices, taking away from what we need to do most, and that's provide veterinary care for our patients.
Some lawmakers and even some pet owners see the legislation as more unneeded red tape coming out of Washington.
If you can show that there is a need for it and the consumer is being cheated or taken advantage of in some way, but the data isn't there.
I think Congress has far more important work to do fixing Obamacare than it does dealing with pet medicine.
It's still too early to tell if bills before the House and Senate will gain enough traction to come up for a vote.
Get going, Rosie.
I'm Christine Frizzow reporting.
And coming up next on Fox Rochester, a warning from the state for area pet owners. And a quirky new addition to the Lilac Festival that can save you time and help out a good cause.
Save on over 2,000 vehicles at DoanDelivers.com.
Ideas for the future.
Design for the future.
Passion for the future.
Inventions for the future.
Imagine the future.
Innovate the future.
Create the future.
Experience the future at Imagine RIT this Saturday, May 7th.
All signs point to an early spring, so it's time to lock in your pre-season pricing with Quality Homes of Rochester and get a complete new roof for as little as $49.90. Vinyl siding starts at $59.90. A house full of vinyl replacement windows as low as $41.90. Quality Homes can reno a kitchen or bathroom, put up an addition, or finish your basement. Low monthly payment and finance options available. Ken McClure and his team want to get your spring home improvement job booked today. So call Quality Homes of Rochester now for pre-season pricing. 429-5400. QualityHomesRochester.com.
It's May, New York, and guess what? The Facilos are throwing a huge extravaganza. Look at the pre-owned inventory.
Millions of dollars.
Yes.
Speaking of millions.
Once again, speaking of millions, a $250,000 giveaway happening this month. Register to win a piece of the pie. No purchase necessary. 23
winners. And one of those lucky winners is going to be huge for a week at Billy's Place in Jamaica.
That's right.
Taking my jet.
Yeah, and that is.
Come in and register. It's going to be huge.
Chacha's Wood-Fired Bar and Grill features the finest in Italian and American cuisine. Thursday, buy any pizza and get 10 boneless wings on the house. Saturday, 6-ounce filet with two sides for $19.99. And don't forget to make reservations for Mother's Day. Cha-cha-cha!
What's the best thing about Leo's? Everything!
Like red velvet cakes, heart-shaped cookie trays, hand-dipped cupcakes, and more for Mom.
Leo's Bakery and Deli.
And Cafe.
So sweet, so sweet.
East Rochester.
It is not uncommon to see these coyotes this time of year. The DEC is urging people to be on alert for them because they are becoming less afraid of humans. 13 WHAM's Amy Hudak is live now with tips to keep the coyotes at a safe distance. We really don't have anything to fear, but our pets do, right?
Absolutely, Jenny, that's right. The DEC and a local vet is recommending that all cats stay inside no matter what time of the day, keep them indoors, and that dogs, especially at night, are taken out on a leash with the owner nearby because these coyotes, especially this time of year, they are out and they are looking for food for their pups, and unfortunately, pets and small pets are often prey.
All right, you didn't see any coyotes out there tonight, did you?
No, but my photographer, John, and I were looking for quite some time. We really worked. We found probably about 40 deer, but no coyotes.
But you did run into a family who had one on their property, right? What happened?
Yeah, absolutely. As a matter of fact, it was a man who works at the DEC. So imagine that. He's a and his wife is a biologist there. She was taking her two labs for a walk last week, and she said she heard like a little bit of yipping and thought another dog was chasing she and her two dogs, and it ended up being a coyote, and it was a frightening experience for her.
Oh, I'm sure. All right, good advice to be on the lookout for. Amy Hudak live tonight on Coyote Watch. Out-of-state students could be paying more for tuition at SUNY schools next year. Provision in the recently passed state budget freezes the tuition at the current level, but does allow an increase of up to 10% at some schools for students who live out of New York. Kettle corn's a staple of pretty much any festival, including the Lilac Festival, but the lines to order can be long. And that's where radio personality Shane Allen comes in. What started as a joke turned into the real deal after he received positive responses from his Craigslist ad. He's decided to charge a small $3 fee to stand in line for you during the Lilac Festival to get your kettle corn. Allen plans to donate the money he makes to the Breast Cancer Coalition of Rochester.
Kettle corn, huge. Here in Rochester, it's like everybody forgets that kettle corn exists until the Lilac Festival, and then everybody gets into a giant line. So I figured, why not try to help them out and be a line stander for them?
Standing in line so you don't have to. Information on how to get in touch with Alan is available on 13wham.com. And coming up next, Glenn has your Lilac Festival forecast, plus the unusual light show over Brooklyn. And it's not so much what he was reading, but where he was reading that has the internet abuzz.
The Dorschel family has lived in and served Western New York. The most important thing we've learned during that time is that each customer is unique and has different needs. That's why we put so much effort into training our people, updating our facilities, and dramatically changing our sales process to recognize the different needs of each customer. I'm in the dealerships every day, striving to make our family business best in class at being there for the things our customers need most. So log on at Dorschel.com or stop in on West Henrietta Road so we can deliver what you need most.
For over 60 years, family-owned Skips on the Ridge has delivered the personal, one-on-one service Rochester families have grown to love. You can't afford to skip Skips on the Ridge.
Hey,
is my job to protect you.
I can't stay at home and do nothing.
This is Gotham City.
Monday at 8 on Fox Rochester.
The backyard of my dreams. No matter the event, no matter the season. With Cambridge Paving Stones, our dreams are the life of the party.
And only Cambridge Paving Stones have Armor Tech, our unique process that produces a rich color that will look the same for years to come.
The reality is, with Cambridge, the only limit is your wildest dreams.
Cambridge Paving Stones with Armor Tech.
Here's a great idea. You know that room you want to redo? Make it fresh and beautiful in just 3 days. Guaranteed. During the home makeover sale at Raymour & Flanigan, your new room is more affordable than ever. Save up to 25% on living, dining, and bedrooms. Up to 20% on select outdoor furniture. Plus, another great idea. No interest for 48 months. The home makeover sale. Going on now at Raymour & Flanigan.
Two names say it all.
The 2016 Hole-in-One Golf Book is on sale now. Go to holeinonegolfbook.com.
Tutti mi chiedono, tutti mi vogliono, donne ragazzi, vecchie fanciulle, quella parrucca, resto barba, quella sanguigna, resto biglietto, sono e vado a tutte la città.
Weeknights at 6 and 6:30 on Fox Rochester.
Well, maybe you're heading out to Highland Park. They got the parade going on tomorrow morning. I think it starts about 10:30 in the morning, and we think the weather's going to cooperate. We're going to be starting out in the 50s. We think by, well, the middle of the day, we should be up around 65. We're looking for a high temperature near 70. And then late in the afternoon, we think there's going to be the chance of a shower. Now, there's going to be some changes through the weekend. There's going to be a cold front that comes through Saturday night, and that means much cooler weather. It's going to be breezy for Mother's Day, unfortunately. I think the morning's dry, and then there's going to be the chance of a shower. Maybe some thunder as we go through the afternoon. Right now we got 55 degrees, no wind to speak of, at least right now this evening. And you can see on the radar we got some showers, and they're not coming in from the west side, they're coming in from the east side. So you go out towards Syracuse, they're right on the edge of some of these downpours, and you can see it extends all the way out to Utica. And we think eventually this is going to reach Rochester later tonight. Now, I think they're going to weaken significantly by the time they get here, but anytime around 1:30, 2, 3 o'clock in the morning, we may get one of these little showers, again, coming in through the Finger Lakes. But once we get into the morning, I think we dry things out again, and we'll find a blend of clouds and sunshine as we progress through the morning. And as we mentioned, it should be warming up pretty rapidly. So finally, well, I guess we can say we deserve some warmer weather here. So we're going to be up around 70, at least before the next front comes through, and you can see a couple of showers developing late in the afternoon, but we think most of the day is going to be rain-free. Now, let's show you Sunday here, and we'll stop it right there. Sunday morning, 8 o'clock in the morning, it's going to be dry. We're going to get some sunshine. You're going to need the jacket, no doubt about that, but you can see some of these hit-and-miss showers starting to pop up, maybe even a downpour, maybe even a little rumble of thunder. Temperature-wise here, we're up and down and all over the place, even as we go through the next 7 days. So it cools down into Sunday and into Monday, and then gradually we'll get some warmer weather as we go through the middle of next week. So the weather forecast for tonight, we're down to about 48 degrees. Another shower developing late tonight, maybe a little fog in the valleys. Tomorrow morning, we start out at 52 degrees, a mix of clouds and sunshine. Most of the day is going to be rain-free. We think late in the afternoon, the chance of rain starts to increase a little bit. The high is going to be near 70, and if we don't get a shower late in the afternoon, we're probably going to see one once we go into tomorrow evening. The extended outlook, we go into Sunday. Yeah, you can see breezy, cooler weather. Temperatures are going to be in the 50s on Sunday, maybe near 60 on Monday. Dry weather for Tuesday, and then we'll get some of these hit-and-miss showers going into Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. Spring showers in Rochester.
Yeah, all kinds of critters in the spring, right?
Yeah.
A goose is attracting a lot of attention in Webster. It decided to roost right next to the entrance of Kmart. Caution tape has been put up to protect the goose. Wow. And customers, it's against the law to harass a nesting migratory bird. So you can check out the blue light special, but stay away from the goose. All right, what's tonight's...
Don't break the law. Well, you saw just a few minutes ago, the radio personality that will wait in line for your kettle corn
for a donation to charity at the Lilac Festival. That got us to thinking tonight, what would you wait in line for at the Lilac Festival? Or in our Twitter poll, what is your favorite classic food at the Rochester Lilac Festival? Couldn't list them all, so we picked four. And of the 300 of you who responded, 25% said kettle corn, 24% said deep fried Oreos, 37% went with me, the funnel cakes. 14%, yeah. This is another good favorite, the cinnamon roasted almonds. There are so many items to choose from, so we could only list four, but the funnel cakes wins this year.
All right, our producer goes for the garbage plate at the Lilac Festival.
He likes fried Oreos too,
the whole
I think.
Thing. Good for him. When we come back on Fox, how the Bodie McBoatface saga came to an end.
The 10 o'clock news is brought to you by the Rochester area Ford dealers.
Make your lawn the envy of the neighborhood with Turfline Fertilizer. Quality products, local knowledge, and local support that only comes from a local company. Turfline Fertilizer, locally produced since 1956.
I've accepted myself as a 400-pound person.
Morbidly obese, living a life without hope.
And then it finally dawned on me, I'm missing everything. I'm missing life.
One woman's journey toward reclaiming her life. Monday on 13 Wham News at 11.
And we're off with another great deal with award-winning 14 Hands wine for $5.99. Hi, it's Leanne from Lisa's Liquor Barn. 14 Hands in eight varietals like Hot to Trot, Red and White, Stampede, Red Blend, and more. You pay $7.99 per bottle and save even more with a $24 mail-in rebate. Your final cost just $5.99. That's right, just $5.99. Only at Lisa's Liquor Barn in Penfield. Why pay more?
Two replacement windows. Can you see the difference? Theirs has a tilt and sash. So does Window World's. Our window carries the Good Housekeeping seal and will save you on your heating and cooling bills. So does theirs. Both windows come with a lifetime warranty. The difference between these two windows isn't the quality. The difference is the price. Window World, $299 installed. Theirs, $400 or more. Check it out for yourself. Compare Window World's price to theirs. Then compare our quality. I'm so sure it measures up that I not only stand behind our window, I'm standing on it. Can you stand on theirs? Well, maybe, but it will cost you. Window World, a quality window at a fair price. $2.99 per window installed. Call 288-8888. 288-8888. That's Window World, simply the best for less. At Window World, we don't just stand behind our windows, we stand on them.
Kids, get ready for the best week of summer. Vacation Bible School at Hope Church is open to kids ages 3 through 8th grade. We've got games, music, indoor and outdoor fun, and it's free. Sign up today at sharethehope.org.
Do it yourself and save with Turfline's 4-step program. Hurry into Green Acres for a Turfline Premium 4-step program, now with grub control and fertilizer in one application. Green Acres Farm, Ladder Road in Greece, for all your lawn and garden needs.
Rochester Colonial.
He's a proud sponsor of the 13 Wham Weather Line. Call 334-0013 to get the latest forecast anytime from the 13 Wham Weather Authority.
The artist spent 10 months putting the show together and training the pigeons. The show runs on weekends through June 12th. Well, you can find all kinds of things in Washington, D.C., especially on the subways, but this is unusual. A beaver made its way through the metro station, and people were able to capture it on some video, even let it kind of nuzzle up to it, whatever. The beaver got on the yellow line and went back home. And now our good day, bad day.
A bad day for Beyonce. Not everybody is a fan. This guy would rather read a book at her concert. Now her fans are saying even if he liked it, he should have put a bookmark in it. And a good day for this London restaurant. It doesn't open until June and already 32,000 people are on the waiting list. Well, the food may not be the draw. This restaurant is clothing optional.
Oh, come on. You exo appalled?
Who wants to eat? Never mind. Really?
Yeah, well, it's optional, so you could go clothed. And
go somewhere else.
Have your dessert.
When they asked me to go. Bill's rookie doesn't quite understand buffalo chicken wings. Really? And the Rhinos try to get another win at home. Sports is coming up next.
On the next outrageous episode of Crazy Talk, Papa Polygraph is getting silly in Philly.
Have you ever had sex with my mom?
And Malaysia from Basketball Wives.
I wake up in the morning and I just play.
Tonight at 11 on Fox Rochester.
Looking for an apartment? Go online anytime. RentRochester.com.
13 Wham News. Makeup provided by MAC.
Here's a great idea. You know that room you want to redo? Make it fresh and beautiful in just 3 days. Guaranteed. During the home makeover sale at Raymour & Flanigan, save 20% on this queen bedroom set, 25% on this chenille sofa. Save up to $1,000 on mattress sets, and queen lifestyle adjustable bases start at just $5.99. Plus, no interest for 48 months. The home makeover sale, only at Raymour & Flanigan.
Two names say it all.
First impressions are everything, especially online. Get a website that creates a great first impression from Webwa. For less than $1,000, Webwa can build you a new mobile-friendly website, and they can get you on the first page of Google for just $189 a month. Webwa is a local Rochester-based company, and they specialize in designing websites for small businesses just like yours. Call Webwa today at 444-8808.
I just bought a huge supply of automatic standby generators at drastically discounted pricing. I can't think of a better time to get one than when the threat is the biggest, and that's right now. Never worry about power failures again. Never. The next big outage is only a matter of when, not if. They turn on automatically and run on natural gas. So call Anderson today for drastically discounted pricing.
For a clean, safe, comfortable life.
Tap into Anderson.
Fox Monday.
It's my job to protect you.
I can't stay home and do nothing.
This is Gotham City.
A new Gotham, then.
This case could offer evidence of life after death.
Never trust what you don't see with your own eyes.
An all-new Houdini and Doyle.
Monday at 8 on Fox Rochester.
Come sail away with the American Cancer Society.
Carpus Investment Management proudly presents the Celebrate Hope Gala on June 4th.
Support the B. Thomas Golisano Hope Lodge Hospitality House. Get your tickets online or call 224-4928.
Now, 13 Wham Sports, driven by Bob Johnson Chevrolet.
Yeah, the Bills opening up their rookie minicamp today. Two of the top picks can't wait to work together. The new QB met the legend, and a free agent doesn't get the whole buffalo chicken wing thing. With more, here's Jenna and Toby.
Hi, Mike. Jenna Cottrell joining me out here in Orchard Park. First day of rookie minicamp for the Buffalo Bills. Kind of a tease as to what this team is going to be once we hit OTAs, of course, in a couple of weeks. But Jenna, Rex Ryan seemed pretty pumped to see his guys out there today.
He was talking about the fact that it's finally so much preparation going into the draft and just seeing them out in the Bills uniform, and there's a lot of size out there. That's one of the things that struck me, just seeing this defense kind of come into its form.
Yeah, we do talk about the defense. That really is where the Bills went in the first three rounds of the draft. Boom, 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 defense, defense, defense. You talk about excitement. Those guys were really the ones who were excited to be out there today as well.
Great to put this uniform on and great to be with my new team and my new home. So I felt great going back out there today.
I know the expectations for a professional player. I felt like I did pretty good at, you know, picking up on the first day installment that they had. You know, I came in with the mindset that I'm willing to play wherever I need to get on the field and contribute.
All right, now the first offensive player the Bills took in the draft was right after that in round four. It was a quarterback. And a pretty high-profile one at that.
Yeah, another quarterback coming into Orchard Park, Cardale Jones out of Ohio State. He's got incredible arm strength. Today he was really working on his footwork, though.
Yeah, working with a lot of the Bills coaches, obviously. But on his way over to the media to meet us all for the first time at the podium, he met up with the greatest Bills quarterback of all time, Jim Kelly.
Grayson encouraged me, just saying, you know, it's the first day. Keep your head up, you look good, things like that.
Now, all of these guys, of course, Jenna, are getting acclimated to their new surroundings. They're from all across the country, but they're also getting acclimated to the food. How about undrafted free agent linebacker Eric Stryker?
Buffalo and buffalo wings. That's all you need to know. He was talking about how he's never really tried an authentic buffalo wing, which is, of course, a chicken wing.
Of course it is. And you know what? We're just going to let Eric tell you for himself. He's going to be a little surprised.
In my mind, I'm like, I've tasted a great chicken wing. How better can it be here? I mean, what else can you do to a chicken wing? Is all I'm saying. So what place do I need to go to? Is it Duff's?
Yes.
Duff's is where I need to go?
Now, where exactly he decides to go, we should probably keep our eyes on Twitter for that one. But it really, this was a fun rookie class. This seems like a group of guys that's going to have a good time out there.
A lot of personality. Of course, Rex himself with a lot of personality. Like we said, he doesn't really stifle those personalities, but we should be in for quite an entertaining show this upcoming season.
And our next view of that ridiculousness with all the veterans included as well, that, of course, is coming up in organized team activities. Those don't start until May 23rd. And then, of course, training camp sometime toward the end of the summer. We'll see. Reporting with Jenna Cottrell, I'm Toby Matika. Back to you, Mike.
All right, thanks, guys. Hey, the Rhinos, winners of the first two home matches, took on Charleston tonight. Steven Dos Santos made his return following a suspension against Charleston. 15th minute, Rochester up 1-0. Zach Prince feeds the ball between two Rhinos right to Romario Williams, who ties the matchup at one. Then in the 29th, Dos Santos flicks it to himself over the head of two defenders. But Canardo Forbes there to clean up the rebound and the lead. Tied at two after the 75th minute. Handball for Tony Wells with a chance to get the lead on the penalty kick. And he gets it. The Rhinos get a win tonight. The final score, 3-2. How about lacrosse tonight? Cam Isaac and RIT starting postseason play and league playoffs against Union College. Tigers already up 1-0 early. Pass comes out to Alex Zaleski here, and he gets the feet moving by the defender, finds Kyle Sturzen here for the score. After Union ties it at four midway through the second, it stirs and storms towards the net, gets knocked to the ground, but still scores. Tigers pulling away in the second. There Sturzen again, plays the pick and roll with Braden Wallace for the goal. RIT rolls to the win today. Final 21-9. Hey, the New York State High School Lacrosse Championships are coming back to town. St. John Fisher will host the state semis and finals for at least the next 3 years, from 2017 to 19. The states were here 3 years ago. High schools from tonight, we've got baseball. Third-ranked Class A team in the state, that's Arcadia, hosting Crosstown Odyssey this afternoon. Titans already up 4-1 in the sixth. Kevin Blum gets a piece of this one down the first baseline. That brings in Brian Rivera. Arcadia then brings in big ol' Anthony Kane to close it out. He needs just three pitches. They win. Titans' 15th win of the year. When we come back, the Yankees with an exciting game tonight against the Red Sox.
We are Renewal by Anderson,
the most recognized window brand in the industry.
With over 110 years of experience,
innovative Energy Star windows and doors.
And most importantly, our dedication to complete customer satisfaction.
Changing the home improvement industry forever.
One window at a time, one customer at a time.
We are Renewal.
Renewal. Renewal by Anderson.
Zero interest loans available for qualified buyers. RenewalByAnderson.com.
Before earning enough cash back from Bank of America to buy a new gym bag, before earning 1% cash back everywhere, every time, and 2% back at the grocery store, even before he got 3% back on gas, Kenny used his Bank AmeriCard Cash Rewards credit card to join the Wednesday Night League, because he loves to play hoops, not jump through them. That's the excitement of rewarding connections. Apply online or at a Bank of America near you.
building, remodeling, home improvement. Choose a local professional at findthehomepros.com.
Two episodes left. So many surprises. The Last Man on Earth.
Sunday at 9:30.
Save on over 2,000 vehicles at DoanDelivers.com.
All right, it's just May, but the last place Yanks started the night 7 full games behind the Red Sox. This was a wild one tonight. David Ortiz, quite a night. Of course, he loves to hit in the Bronx, and he does here. 2-run homer for Boston. They lead it 2-0, but the Yanks would come back to tie it up at 2. And then former Red Wing Aaron Hicks picks a good time to hit his first Yankees home run. This in the bottom of the 7th. Yanks lead 3-2, but then it got crazy in the 9th. Base is full for Ortiz. 3-1 pitch. Wow, Brian McCann doesn't handle it very well. Ortiz doesn't think it was a strike. He argues, and then his manager, John Farrell, comes out. Farrell gets ejected. But now it's still a 3-2 count on Ortiz. Oh, a called third strike. He didn't like that. He flips out a little bit. Farrell never left the dugout, but Ortiz did. Came out to yell, got his money's worth for getting ejected. The Yankees hold on and win it tonight, the final 3-2. NHL quickly tonight, Ryan Callahan telling the Islanders, I live up near Lake Ontario. It's a nice area. You guys should come visit. Well, maybe it was something like that. This game went to overtime, and in the OT, it's the Lightning getting the win. They take it by a final 2-1. They lead that series 3-1.
Good lip reading.
Yeah, it was pretty close to that.
Yeah, I think so.
It's going to be dry most of the day. Temperature near 70 for the afternoon.
All right, we hope you have a great weekend. Enjoy the weather, and we'll be back on Channel 13 at 11 with Don Elhart. Thanks for watching 13 Wham at 10 here on Fox Rochester.
Make your...
Someone random. Hey, I'm your daughter. Aww.
But then something unexpected. Choking back tears, he tells Janet he always wanted a little girl.
Bye-bye. Oh, that broke my heart. He's crying.
I know. A few days later, father and daughter meet for the first time.
Oh,
I'm so good to see you. I love you like my little girl.
Little did Kent know he's also a grandfather.
Yeah,
and Janet wasn't the only one who got to meet her birth father. Julie meets her birth father, Bobby.
Hi. Julie? Yes.
Bobby.
Nice to meet you.
Wow, you do look like my mom.
Who immediately takes out a photo of his mother. There is a striking similarity.
That's scary how much I look like her.
After an afternoon of catching up on a lifetime.
Oh, it's really nice to meet you.
Goodbyes and promises to keep in touch. But Dean's reunion with his father is not to be, at least not yet. Even though Dean has his name, he can't find him. Could he be watching tonight? As for Joanne, she made it through her surgery. It's now been 6 weeks.
Hi. Time to see. You look good.
Group hug, yeah, please. Group hug.
Now the really hard healing can begin. Cece predicts Joanne's toughest critics will be herself and the millions of viewers she confessed to tonight.
She will be judged, unfortunately. And I just don't think that judgment helps anyone. I've learned that families are the most forgiving, loving people when they grow up that I've ever met. They want that connection, and so in order to have that and foster it, you have to let go all of that negativity.
A recipe for redemption. A family is building their own new memories together. A first haircut for a grandson. A backyard barbecue. And a toast to a once torn fabric now stitched together into a portrait of a family.
Cheers.
Cheers
to that.
Cheers to family.
Cheers.
Salute.
So you just heard Cece Moore talk about that judgment. How do you judge what that mother did? As her child, could you forgive her? Let us